Hey all, here OS Reviews. You're watching our hands-on comparison between the MobVoi TicWatch Pro versus the TicWatch 2. The TicWatch Pro is the company's latest smartwatch and uses the Google Android Wear OS versus the TicWatch 2, which was kind of their first generation crowdsourced project that actually used a proprietary system, including a different UI UX built on top of Android and a proprietary app store. Both of these are relatively affordable smartwatches as well, the MobVoi Pro coming priced at $250 and being marketed as a premium smartwatch with a real leather band, as well as this very sporty, athletic, premium look, as well as the TicWatch 2, which came out for only $200. Let's take a closer look at the design of both watches first. So, the interesting thing here is both of these watches have the same display size, measuring 1.4 inches diagonally, and they are round displays. They don't have any kind of flat tires in the same style as the Moto 360s, so they are both pretty elegant looking. They also have the same pixel density of 400 by 400 pixels, and they're both using, again, AMOLED technology. After a few seconds, both of these watches begin to time out, and that's where we notice the biggest difference, which is the TicWatch Pro has a secondary display, which is using an LCD technology, kind of similar to e-paper or e-ink. This is compared to the TicWatch 2, which is also clever because AMOLED technology doesn't consume as much power when there's a darker theme. In fact, when it's black, all the pixels are technically turned off. So it goes into this always-on mode, which only shows some basic kind of tick marks as well as the hands of a clock. It's able to drain power a lot more slowly, but still give you an always-on experience. However, it's one display compared to the two displays being used on the Pro, and it's slightly less easy to see in outdoor environments because it's still a AMOLED smartphone-like display. Taking a look at the dimensions and the overall construction style, we also see some pretty big differences, which is that the TicWatch 2 is more of a casual smartwatch. It's kind of an everyday smartwatch that folks maybe working in offices would want to wear, compared to the TicWatch Pro, which although can also be worn in offices because it has a professional leather strap, is a lot larger and heftier. It definitely has a more sports-like appearance. It also makes it feel slightly more expensive, but at the result, it's a lot heavier. It's also going to take up more room on your wrist, so if you have smaller hands, that's definitely something to consider. Overall, this one is also a lot slimmer as well, so it definitely feels like you're wearing something that is not quite as obtrusive on your arm when you're going through your daily activities. On the back, we also see some differences in the material choices. We have access to ceramic on the TicWatch 2, and because it is made out of ceramic, it also features Qi for wireless charging. It's magnetic as well, and this is what its charging cradle looks like. It simply pops on very elegantly just to quickly top it off. Compared to the TicWatch Pro, which is using these four contact points, more common in other wearables, as well as a heart rate sensor in the back, to charge it up like this. The final difference design-wise would be navigational controls. We do have two crown keys, which can wake up the display, take you through the various menus, and for selecting things like a sports or activity that you want to time and track. And that's compared to the TicWatch 2, which has just one key, dubbing as waking up the display, and it also has what's called a tickle bar, so it's a capacitive strip on the edge of the watch, which you can use to navigate between lists and kind of scrolling back and forth. So again, it is using a touch sensor as opposed to physical keys, which are more useful if your hands are maybe wet, if you're outdoors. Again, this is more of a rugged design compared to this, which is lighter, but it does also have a more modern touch as a result. You can also see a slight difference in how the displays are constructed, because on the TicWatch 2, it almost feels like the display is floating on top because the Gorilla Glass is slightly raised, and it seems like the display is just spilling out, giving you kind of an infinity experience compared to the TicWatch Pro, which is inside just to protect it from damage. As aforementioned, the differences here are between Android Wear and MobVoi's own system. So if we take a look at what MobVoi offers first, we can tap on the display to wake it up. Gestures also include flicking the display up to automatically unlock it when you bring it to your face. And these are gestures which are shared again on both of these watches. Pretty typical for wearables these days. I can long hold on the main screen here to change the watch face, which with the Android Wear 2.0 update that we saw just a few days ago, has also brought that feature along to Android Wear. So now we have the same same gesture on both watches, and I can pick from a number of different faces, whether more digital, whether more professional, to customize it with. There's a good selection on both, but Android Wear definitely has a slight edge in terms of customization, just because it's a more popular platform and there's more designers working on faces that you can either purchase or download for free from the Play Store, but you get a fair selection on both. I can swipe over from the left to bring up the voice search command. So you can tap on this, and it is using proprietary technology from MobVoi, which is a company based in China, and a big reason why they started this project is because Google services are banned there, so they aren't able to use things like Assistant on their smartwatches. Now, the Google Wear 2.0 has a very similar kind of layout now, where you can also swipe over to the left to access the Assistant panel that gives you things like updates, weather information. You can tap on this to immediately start searching Google Assistant through voice commands. Over onto the right is where we have a list of all of our applications, which are vertically scrolling, and then we have a vertical scrolling list like so, compared to icons on the MobVoi-based OS. So that's a slight difference there. On the MobVoi, in terms of pre-included applications, there's a health app here, which is basically the same health app as we saw on the TicWatch Pro. It looks, again, pretty much identical to the one on the TicWatch 2. I can pull up to take a look at number of steps, distance, exercise minutes, active hours, and calories burned, so very similar on both. I can move over to the right to take a look at steps, and each of these individual categories one by one. So this entire app has been borrowed basically from the TicWatch 2 and implemented as a secondary app on top of Android Wear. So that's why they look so similar on both of these watches. And you'll also find some utilities like a voice recorder and a calculator built right on in, which is actually one of my favorite parts about the TicWatch 2 when I reviewed it, was attention to some of these smaller details, which work actually really well from an interface perspective. The keys would shift left and right depending on what buttons you need to access, and having a voice recorder is actually one of a few features that are commonly undervalued or undermined by other manufacturers. Just being able to tap on this key to record any thoughts is really quite handy. It's something that actually you don't get on the TicWatch Pro because Wear OS doesn't have a voice recorder app by default. So you can find a version that you may want from the Play Store and then download it yourself. Dragging down, I can turn off kind of wireless options. I can see my battery status remaining. I can also drag up to take a look at notifications. So all of these are, again, very similar now to Android Wear 2.0 notifications, as well as our status information for things like battery, as well as whether Wi-Fi is turned off, things like that. They both have 512 megabytes of RAM. They both have 4 gigs of built-in storage, but over here we have a MediaTek chipset, but on the TicWatch Pro we have a Snapdragon quad-core chipset. It's the Snapdragon Wear 2100 series. It's loosely based on the Snapdragon 400 from smartphones. So on paper it's a more powerful, you know, CPU, and technically it should be able to perform better and perform more graphically intensive apps, but because of Android Wear being kind of a heavier OS, at least to what we were able to access, it seems like there's more stuff installed on it. As a result, it does feel sometimes slightly slower. Both watches do come with built-in GPS, so it's able to track your location on a map if you're running outside. And they both have the same selection of activities that you can track, including outdoor running, indoor walking, outdoor running, and cycling as well. So the number of activities is pretty much identical. So if you're using this to run outside and then sync it with a phone to see your path on a map, you'll get pretty identical results. Number of steps are also within 10 to 20 steps in terms of difference between the two when I did a test earlier, so not a huge difference there. I will say though that the TicWatch Pro has a larger capacity pack. It's able to cram in more juice because of a thicker body, and because it also has that secondary display, it does conserve on battery a little bit better. It's able to last me in regular use, that includes with Bluetooth turned on and taking a look at notifications every once in a while. It'll last me for about 3 to 4 days on a single charge compared to the TicWatch, which is something that needs to be charged every 2 days pretty consistently, sometimes a day and a half. Other elements, including access to content, so again, the Play Store is definitely far richer compared to the MobVoi store, just because this is a lot newer and it only has a handful of apps there. So compared to the Android Wear OS, it already has hundreds of titles that you can find, so that is, again, one benefit of going with a larger ecosystem product. Otherwise, in terms of voice searching, the biggest surprise for me, at least, was again the fact that MobVoi's system is a little faster. It's also extremely, extremely accurate. It's super ambitious as well, because there aren't many startup companies that are willing to go against, you know, a huge giant like Google and proclaim that their kind of voice search technology is better. That's pretty much it as far as our hands-on comparison between these two smartwatches from MobVoi. I would say that they're catering for two slightly different lifestyles. I would say that the Tick Watch 2 is better for the typical consumer that isn't doing quite as much outdoor-type sports because it's more delicate in its build, it's not nearly as premium, doesn't feel quite as rugged. Also lighter, it feels more comfortable when you're wearing it in the day-to-day. It also feels more sleek and kind of what a wearable of the future would and probably should look like. For most customers in 2018, considering that the price differences are only around $50 apart, I would probably point you in the direction of the Tick Watch Pro, just because I think that it's only going to get better with more software updates from Google, and in addition, it has a better battery life, which I think is probably one of the most important facets of any smartwatch. However, if you are someone who isn't quite as focused on, you know, tracking too much sports, you're not really into too much outdoor type activities, you just want something light for notifications and good voice searches, then the Tick Watch 2 is still an excellent choice to consider, mostly because of how elegant and beautiful it's constructed. You can check out more details about both in the links down below. But that's been our video. Thanks for watching here at OS Reviews.